Why did Airbus build the A318 baby bus? The Airbus A318 is the smallest Airbus commercial passenger plane flying today in terms of length, at only 31.44 metres or 103 foot 2 inches long. But why is it so small? And why was it even built? We delve into the wonderful world of the Airbus A318 baby bus. Originally, Airbus came to the market with the Airbus A320 as a small, short-haul aircraft. This garnered plenty of attention and in 1997 resulted in Airbus entering a partnership with China and Singapore to deliver a new aircraft in the 100-seater range. This new aircraft was codenamed the AE-31X program and would be two different aircraft called the AE-316 and AE-317. It would fly 2,000 nautical miles or 3,700 kilometers and seat up to 125 passengers in a 3-2 cabin configuration, a spec that sounds somewhat similar to the Airbus A220 that would come 20 years later. Alas, differences around the direction of the project came to a head. Market research showed demand for a sub-100-seater aircraft, and the Chinese partners wanted a 150-plus-seater aircraft. This would come dangerously close to the market occupied by the A320. With a weak business case, the project was abandoned. Well, not entirely. Airbus decided to move forward with its concept, but base it on the A320 frame. They shrunk the A320 down to the A319 and then further shrank it to produce the A318. This way, they could reach the few customers that had shown interest in the AE-31X program without having to develop the clean sheet design. This version would have some unique advantages beyond being built on the same line as the A320. It would sport more powerful engines and be able to fly up to 136 passengers to a bigger range of 3,100 nautical miles or 5,740 kilometers. It would not be so easy for Airbus to bring the concept to market. The development of the Airbus A318 is one that was littered with problems. The first was a lack of demand for aircraft after the 2001 9/11 attacks. Additionally, many of the airlines that had shown interest in the type backed out of full orders, such as Air China, British Airways and Transworld Airlines, who had an order of 50 Airbus A318s but cancelled after being acquired by American Airlines. Other airlines upgraded their orders to the bigger A319 and A320 after the A318 proved to be too niche. Worst of all, when the aircraft was being certified by the FAA and EASA, because it was built on a bigger frame of the A320, it was not classed as a regional jet. This meant it attracted much higher landing fees for airlines. In the end, only 80 A318 baby bus aircraft were sold, and as of 2020, only 65 are still in operation across 5 airlines. These are Air France, TAROM, British Airways, Titan Airways, and a handful of private or government operators. British Airways operates a special Airbus A318 service from London City to New York JFK via Shannon for refueling. This route is popular with business travelers as passengers can clear US customs in Ireland and land in the US as if it was a domestic flight. The A318 is configured with just 32 lie-flat business class seats and has taken the iconic Concorde flight number BA1. Unfortunately, rumours have it that soon this service would be suspended due to low demand. Today, the type is becoming increasingly rare. The components themselves are cross-compatible with the rest of the A320 range, and as such, they can often be worth more than the aircraft itself. After all, you can technically buy a whole plane of A320 parts for the cost of a cheaper A318, especially on the second-hand market. If you like this video, please like and subscribe to the Simple Flying channel, and be sure to click the notification bell.